Hello, my name is Mordred Viking, and I'd like to welcome you to episode 25 of this Let's Play Europa Universalis IV. This is the March of the Vikings, and we are Mordgard. In the last episode, we spent most of our time preparing for the next war, which will be against Manas and Undra, I think, because we have got a whole bunch of claims over there. In the meantime, we are building another stack so that we are perfectly positioned to go and kick some arse, and we seem to be taking attrition. That is not acceptable. Is that because Bataan is going to collapse soon? Let's try putting you here. Supply limit of 41. That's much better. And yes, Bataan is indeed the province which looks most set to explode. Morale has been activated. These troops are beginning to appear. Large number of new guys. That's excellent. We're still training more, though. That cannon's going to take a long time. We're going to cancel that cannon, and we're going to build another one here instead. Still takes a long time. We'll build it there instead. Okay. So we're going to be one cannon short, but the rest of it should all get into position. Those cannons should be coming in now. Yes, they are. Good. And where is this? This is... Right, Majafit. Majafit was the other one that we were going to go for. Are we able to fabricate some more claims? We are. Excellent. I think I would like to grab these two if possible. Palembang definitely being the more valuable right now. Alright. Now, because our aggressive expansion is so high, it's actually Indonesia that we want to go after, so we should start shifting some of these troops over there. I really wish that you would fire. Come on, hurry up. Someone's privateering. Are you privateering me? No. I think you're privateering up here. Yes, you are. The Musaids are privateering Indus, but that doesn't matter to me because we don't collect there. And actually, on that note, let's grab our transports. We'll send them over here, we'll pick up this army, and we'll send them over. The Crown will fund development of the Al-Soldara lands, gain one base tax for 100 admin. That is a terrible price. Bugger off. Oh, come on, just rise. Right. Let's go and stick you guys over here. We'll have to make a couple of journeys, I think. But that's fine. We can just build up even more manpower and stuff like that. We are, in fact, generating it now, which is excellent. You're about to arrive. Blink. And there's the uprising. Go and kill it. Easy. Right then. Let's send one of you over here as well. In fact, you know what? We should send our troops down here. And then our transports don't need to go nearly so far. Where are they now? There they are. Yeah, we'll just go to the Comorin Cape. We'll pick you up in Venad. Next batch. Drop you off over there. And then we can get rid of you. You guys are ready. Yeah, right. I don't want to merge them. And in fact, I can get rid of those four mercenaries. We don't need them anymore because we're not colonizing. So, bye-bye. Thank you for your service and all that. Send you down here. I mean, we're going to keep one army here in Mordgard just in case things kick off. I think that would be entirely reasonable. And then the rest of you can be there ready for the invasion of Indonesia. Excellent. Missionary is almost done. This will take a little while to ship the troops over. We're keeping an army over here just in case another war kicks off in our homelands. You've made it home, and we have another conversion. Jolly good. I could really do a 29 transports, and I could ship the entire army in one go. Yeah, we'll just keep on going on the small provinces, I think. Oh, so how are we doing in terms of accepted cultures? Like, we could really do with Rajput. That would actually increase the amount of stuff that we're getting quite significantly. Cost 100 diplo. I think that's well worth paying. Let's get it. We're 8 years away from the next institution. How far away are we from the next technology? 4 years. Okie dokie. Right, so that's one full army. What's the supply limit here? 29. So, I think we're actually going to wait here. We may as well declare the war once we have one more claim. So we're going to get up to 30 on that, and then we'll declare the war, I think. And there it is. Let's get Bengkulu as well. And then, I think, we're ready for this war. You have no allies. I'm not calling in any of my allies. Our objective right now is Banten. No, we're going to say Palembang, actually, because we can actually hold these immediately. Boom. We need a general, although can we get a better one? Undoubtedly. We'll keep you for now. What's your tech? 14. What's mine? 15? Yeah, it is. I think 15's a big one. So even though there is a straight crossing here, and I kind of don't want to do this. Actually, we'll see what you do. Nothing. Oh, no, you're coming for me. All right, I'll let you take the straight crossing penalty instead. Even better. Let's fight their navies. Oh. -3. Yeah, that would have been horrible. We should absolutely demolish them. Which it looks like we are doing successfully. Huzzah! And you're going to run to Palembang. That's not clever. Right, let's send our ships over here, grab the rest of the army, and then continue with the invasion. Stack wipe? Stack wipe. Must be. Month has not passed. Really? They got away? That's irritating. Alright, let's make sure that we capture both of these. No, actually, you know what? Let's have you guys follow through and take Banten so that we control this strait and we don't need to cross it anymore. And we'll make sure that we're shipping in our reinforcements. You may as well split in half. Should have sent my general here, actually. Queen's reputation tarnished. Some sort of propaganda text is circulating in the court about how Mayor the First is a ruthless power monger. This might impact our relations with other countries. So be it. Alright, next group. On to the army. Sail in. Let's go and send in the reinforcements. Agent was discovered in Undra. That is unfortunate. We've taken Banten. Let's keep moving forward, shall we? Okay. Next group should be arriving very soon. Yes, they are. Need to keep half an eye on what's happening here. Alright, next group. Off we go. I think we're going to do very well here. So actually, any cannons that we have, I want in here, Kowali. Oh, there's their navy. 3 heavy, 17 lights, and 10 transports. 30 ships against my 17. I have more heavies. They will have more lights. We'll have the same number of transports. So I may well want to send my lights along with my main fleet. Kind of surprised they haven't tried to do anything with those ships. Straits of Johor, you're coming back over there, okay. Let's split you out. Split out the cannon, make sure they stay. Then the unit without any of those things can just go and sit over there. And are we getting plus 5? We are. Good. That'll do. So that siege shouldn't take us too long to take. Let's grab another bunch of troops. And also you. And head down to here. Off we go. Where are you sailing to? Mengi Archipelago. We'll meet you there. Nope, you're running. Because I don't want to engage you with these ships. I want to make sure that these aren't close enough, but I would also very much like to drop the soldiers off. So if you're backing off, then that's fine. I will let you. Because I'm just going to hunt you down and kill you. Eventually. It'll happen. A prince consort of the people. We can spend a bunch of money and lose some admin to gain national unrest until Mare dies. Which is not going to be too far away. She's 70. More matters to deal with. Alright, let's sail on, shall we? Okay, their big army has arrived again. But Koali should fall fairly soon. Alright, where is their navy? Sitting in their capital. Unfortunate. Although what I could do is have you guys blockade enemy ports in Eastern Indian Ocean? Are these two different seas? Eastern Indian Ocean, South China Sea. Great, they're two different seas. I guess Eastern Indian Ocean for now. We can always switch them around. We just need to wait for that to fall and then we can go and attack them with both of our armies. Oh, they've left the port. You have a navy, commander. You're on your way. You're a fast ship, so you should arrive fairly quickly. They ran. They lost two heavies and a light. We lost nothing. Excellent. I approve of that. And then let's continue blockading that. Any damage taken? A little bit. Let's go and get that healed off. Oh, you're going to sit in here. No, you are retreating to there. Okay. Come on, take that. Let's go. There we go. You two, attack. We have so much more morale than they do. 3.1 to my 5.7. 2.2 tactics to 1.9. We have no general. Oh, now we do. And now we're kicking their ass. Marvellous! Let's group and then split twice and then one more time. So we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4. End of this month, we'll move you guys out over here again. Seeing as you'll have been fully repaired. I don't think I need to bring in the rest of the troops over here. We're killing their navies pretty easily. Cool. Alright, let's bring you guys up here. And you two over here. Siege down the capital. Now, if we were to take this territory, how much can we take? We can take this for 80 war score. I think this is basically what I'm going to be after as well. Manas, Ratas, Mujafit, Andra, Kosala, Sind. It's a little bit of overextension, but not a huge amount. Oh, you've gone onto an island. Interesting. It's actually not a bad move. Well done. Are we getting siege bonus here? We are. Good stuff. Then split you in half. We'll take the second half and have you blockading enemy ports there. Marath was done, plus we need another advisor. We can do that in just a minute. New advisor, Diplo. Spy network construction. That's actually really good for us. We are paying over the odds for it. I don't think that really matters. We have rather a lot of money. Okay, that siege is not going to take too long. Why are we blockading here? Seems a bit weird. We should be blockading here. Are you guys moving to blockade this? No, you are still moving to random places. Why are we blockading an area that they have no land on? Prince Consort Regency. Alright. Alfred is in charge. But she is an embezzler. No, sorry, he. He is an embezzler. Then Mordred is next up. 350. Man, my rulers have been rubbish. New deity. I think we're going to go with the trade efficiency goods modifier. Core creation cost. You know what? Core creation cost would be really good for us right now. Because we're going to be doing a lot of coring. Odin! Marvelous. 71%. Come on. Come on. Am I at plus 5 here? No, I'm not. We could actually do with some more artillery here. And am I going to have to do landings on Bali? Does it have a connection? No, just to Lombok. Which is, I assume, there. Yep. Alright, we're at 81%. Would you accept this peace deal? No. Plus, I do actually want money from you. Not war reparations, because I want to pick on you again. In less than 10 years. Once we've taken that, I'm hoping that it would be game over. Now they're offering peace, which is a good sign. Okay, yeah. As soon as your capital's gone, you're definitely going to be wanting out. There we go. Low war enthusiasm. You would accept this peace deal. And that is actually way over my overextension. Oh, no, it's not. Shoot, that's... Oh, that's AE. Oh, I don't care about AE down here. The only one I'm bothered about is if... Shura gets involved. I don't think they will. Okay, so I think we're going to go after this. Actually, let's have a look at what's more valuable. You are naval, you are tropical wood, spice. Yeah, this is going to be a really valuable area. Plus, for the trade bonuses, too. I think this is an acceptable piece. We'll take this. Ka-chink, thank you very much. Marvellous. Alright. Let's send our troops back home. And then we'll ship them back home as well. Next up, we could get manpower modifier, of course. I forgot that we'd switched idea group. So right now, we actually want to go military. We have basically no overextension, so let's just core the lot. Like so. And... No, because we're only 2 years ahead. We'll wait for military technology to finish, and then we'll grab that. And then the... Ceylon fleet. Cancel your mission, so you should all blob together again. And likewise with the fleet, first fleet, I think. Which one was it? Yeah, first fleet. Cancel mission. Which means that you lot should be returning. Let's go. Alright, transports can head over there. Alright, really good. That was a good war. We didn't lose too much manpower either, which is awesome. Okay, is that all of you together again? 38. Yes, it is. Protect trade. Once more in Ceylon, right? Right. We now control how much of this trade? 5%. Oh, that's Malacca, not Malacca. Okay, so we're going to have to go up to Pasai for Malacca, which is a little bit more of an important trade route, honestly. Alright, let's get you guys home. We'll just pile you all into one province and then we'll sort you out once you're there. Excellent! Speed 4, let's go! So how much did that piss people off? Shura doesn't seem particularly bothered. You guys hate my guts, but that's really not too surprising. And yes, it will have raised some ire over here. But not a huge amount, actually. Like, Shura is still the most concerning. I really want to go after Manas. We'll have to wait for our troops to come back, obviously, but... Oh, actually, hold up. We want to leave a stack over here because we're definitely going to be getting some rebels. I just need to remember what my army template is. So, create a new unit. Army template is 17210. 17210. You back off. You need to head home. Alright, good stuff. So we'll have two stacks over here, we'll have one stack over here. We can bring these guys home if we need to. The Council of Parma. His Holiness the Pope has tasked a commission of cardinals with addressing the challenges posed by the Protestant movement. While the Catholic faith itself must not be compromised, His Holiness and most cardinals are willing to admit that some Protestant complaints are valid. Therefore, the Council advises many changes to the administration of the Church to stop to absentee bishops and the worldly accesses of the clergy. In addition, several new monastic orders are to be founded to aid the efforts of the Counter-Reformation. Which really hasn't done anything. The Reformation has been rubbish. Has anything actually fallen to it? Just one province. One province of Saxony and that's it. Oh no, this state religion is still Catholic though. Lithuania might become reformed. Maybe. But that's not even a centre of Reformation anymore. Oh yes it is. There's two centres of Reformation, one Reformed, one Protestant. That's going to do nothing. Rubbish. Oh. Austervik fighting Andra. Damn it. Holy War. Andra, Gouda, and Manas. I mean, yes, but I also don't want to piss Shura off, and this is going to piss Shura off. Fine, I'm not committing to this for this war, though. Not in my national interests. Although this is going to lead to another sodding truce. Damn it! Well, you guys can definitely take the brunt of the fighting. I have no interest in doing so. Still 2 years away, so 96. You're like, should we, shouldn't we, should we, shouldn't we? I don't know. Ah. See, I think it's because of the fact that this isn't a war that I started is what's pissing Shura off. If Shura's in the war, then they don't get angry with me taking land. Especially if you're a Shura rival, which I'm not sure you are. You're going to take Galcona, aren't you? No, you're up against Andra. I don't really care about Andra. What land are you claiming? Just those two. Alright. Of course, they're sieging my land down. Because why wouldn't they? It's the best. I'm going to fight to keep them out of my lands, but that's it. Especially as this is a fort. Dunga Singh Brahmpala suspects neighbours. Having a spymaster in our employ has certainly contributed to our intelligence gathering abroad, but Dunga Singh Brahmpala sometimes coordinates counter-espionage as well. Recently, his investigations have uncovered a conspiracy that could only be the work of one of our neighbouring countries. Which neighbour is behind? It remains unclear, but the constant exchanges of information would require those behind it to be close by. Dunga Singh Brahmpala has prepared to round up and harshly question a number of foreign officials who might be involved, but conflicting theories about the culprits leaves it up to the Prince Consort Regent to decide who to target. Our neighbours will probably not appreciate the accusations, but something needs to be done, and fast. So against Kassala, against Manas. Manas, definitely the most likely. I guess I'll send in some troops. Seeing as you've just lost both of your armies. I just don't want this truce to be too big. Because I do want to go after them at some point, though maybe at this point I'm going to go after Kassala. So what I should be doing is, and I can't believe I'm not doing this already, spy network on you. On you. And sure, on you, though I doubt I'm going to get anything from you now. Which is annoying because they are... This war is annoying on so many different fronts. I actually kind of want this to end as a white piece. Bataan, yeah. And we're suffering attrition sitting here. Of course we are. Are we suffering attrition here? No, we're not. Good. Right, do we now have another large group of population? Not really. Mordred the First is now the queen. 350. We've already started coring. Because of this war, it means we're going to get less, but I think we still want core creation cost reduction, just so we can keep the admin points coming in. Or we can go with trade efficiency, but honestly, we don't need the money. Construction cost, tech cost. We're already ahead of time. Again, we don't need the money. Discipline sailor modifier. It's either Tyr or Odin. I think we're going to go with Odin, especially as actually our legitimacy is a little bit low. We'll do that. That's fine. Well connected. Minus 20% advisor costs. Ho ho! Hello! My advisors cost minus 35%. Sweet! Yeah, we're just going to be rolling in money. Even with three level threes. And, like, some of them aren't even, like, the elite ones. Which we can do again. Which will bring us up to 65. It's not the end of the world. An Inquisitor wouldn't be a bad option, because that increases conversion. And Inquisitors are admin, I think, although you're already the cheap one. And I kind of like the spy network and the discipline, so we're going to leave it. It's fine. The House of Afmapa, with the union of Mordred I and Kivutar, we have gained not only a spouse, but also a new ally in the realm. No, his name is not Alpha, it's Mordred. And they're already on low war enthusiasm. Urbanization. While only a small portion of our population live in the cities, the growing prosperity of the merchants' guilds is attracting an increasing number of people from the countryside. Yeah, absolutely. What is their influence right now? 54 goes up to 65. That is acceptable. And Ming is slandering my merchants once again. How could you? And there it is. Andrew will siege Costa to Austervik. Manas will siege Bidar to Mordgard. I didn't even take it. I And of course that pisses Shura right off again. Are you trying to get me killed here? Because it certainly looks that way. For Pete's sake. I didn't even occupy it. How on earth did I get that territory? 37 development one. I think at this point our alliance with Shura is basically over. Yeah, you have just guaranteed a coalition against me. Alright, we're going to send a diplomat to improve relations with you, but I'm not confident it's going to do much. Also, how long is the truce? 1611. Oh, for goodness sake. 15 years. Really? 15 years? It is. Oh, man. I thought the maximum was like 10. Damn it. Alright, well that war's not going to happen for a long time. That war's not going to happen for a long time. Kassala, Western India it is. And also Pasai. Kilwa, Malacca. Which don't really worry me. So as soon as my diplomats get back, we can start one working on you. And one on you. Is that Shura trying to break the alliance? Maybe, maybe not. Oh, and dangerous extension. Oh, so close. At least we have the 10% cheaper core creation. Needs to be done. And with that, we are going to end this episode. So thank you very much for watching. If you're enjoying the series, then please do hit that like button. If you haven't done so already, then do consider subscribing. And if you have any tips or advice for me, let me know in the comments. Thank you very much for watching. I'll catch you next time. Goodbye.